morning, welcome to the news update once again on African Free Press Television. My name is Aritz Afanga. The federal government has appointed Brigadier General Paul T. Boro, retired, as coordinator of the Presidential Amnesty Program. A statement signed by the Special Advisor to the President on Media and Publicity, Mr. Femi Adesina, last night, said the appointment, which took effect, was to alleviate the problems of former Niger Delta militants. Boro is to take over the responsibilities of Kingsley Kuku, the former special advisor to President Jonathan on Niger Delta, who also doubled as coordinator of the amnesty program. The dollar inched up today as traders remain on edge after a China stock market plunge this week and as Federal Reserve winds up a two-day meeting with hopes of some guidance on its plan for raising interest rates. The state government has denied claims that the Senate President Bukola Saraki and the crisis rocking the National Assembly are responsible for the delay in constituting the State Executive Council. In a statement by Senior Special Assistant on Media and Communication to the State Governor Muhyiddin Akoride, the state government described the claims as false, unfounded and insensitive, stressing that Governor Abdul Fattah Ahmed addressed the issue during last week's interactive program. The governor explained that the delayed appointment of commissioners and special advisors was caused by the financial challenges facing the state and the need to adjust government programs and plans accordingly. According to the news agency of Nigeria, the Nigerian army has said a sporadic shooting heard around Damaturu metropolis yesterday was caused by one of its soldiers. The explanation came in a statement issued by the acting director of Army Public Relations, Sani Usman. The Nigerian Army wishes to inform the public and clarify that the sporadic firing heard in Damaturu yesterday evening was a gross act of indiscipline on the part of a soldier who has already been arrested. Military authorities yesterday in Abuja disclosed that another attempt by the Boko Haram terrorist group to attack Buratai, town of Chief of Army Staff Major General Tuku Buratai, on Monday night met a brick wall as troops repelled the attack. Aero Nigeria, which distributes media releases for the Nigerian military, reported yesterday that the attack on Buratai was the fourth since February 2014. For about the fourth time since February 2014, Boko Haram terrorists moved against Buratai, the hometown of Chief of Army Staff Major General Tuku Buratai, last night, which was also the location of a military camp, the army said in a statement. The Oni of Ife, Oba Okunlade Shijuade, reportedly passed on yesterday at 85 years and 7 months. He was born on January 1, 1930. Unconfirmed sources say the monarch, who was said to have been flown out of the country since last Friday, died in the United Kingdom. The federal government has overruled the Joint Administration and Matriculation Board on its new admission policy that recently sparked off protests in parts of the country. The Permanent Secretary, Minister of Education, Mr. Magjon Mwaubiola, disclosed this to State House correspondents yesterday after briefing President Muhammadu Buhari of his ministry's activities and challenges at the presidential villa in Abuja. Jamhad, at its 2015 combined policy meeting, adopted a policy where candidates of universities with surplus applicants for the unified tertiary matriculation examinations are reassigned to other universities with lower number of applicants than their capacities. A federal high court in Abuja has rejected a prayer by 5 senators opposed to the emergence of Bukola Saraki as the Senate's president to stop the upper legislative chamber from constituting its standing and ad hoc committees. The plaintiffs allege that the Senate Standing Orders 2015 was contrived from the amendment of the 2011 version of the orders without following its 2011 edition's relevant provisions and those of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. President Muhammadu Buhari will today leave Abuja for Yaounde, Cameroon, to continue consultative talks with President Paul Biya and other government officials in the ongoing efforts to build a more effective regional coalition against Boko Haram. The talks are expected to focus on the all activation and deployment of multinational joint task force against Boko Haram, which was established under the auspices of the Lake Chad Basin Commission. According to a statement by Special Advisor on Media and Publicity to the President, Femi Adesina, Buhari will be accompanied on the two-day trip by 6 state governors, as well as Permanent Secretary of the Federal Ministry of Defense and the Director General of the National Intelligence Agency. For more news, you can visit www.africanfreepress.com, follow at African Free Press on Twitter, and like African Free Press on Facebook. My name is Aritz Ifan. That was the news update. Good morning, Africa.